package yet?
Gally's just got here. Should have the first batch of illustrations ready by next week.
You sure this is gonna work? I'm used to shouting across the room to you.
I know, but between the delivery service and email, I'm sure everything's gonna be just fine.
I'm gonna miss our morning coffee chat.
Oh, I miss you too.
Bye.
Bye.
You were painting hair, my beautiful creative wife.
You smell like wood chips, oh, master of business. How was your first day?
I'm gonna have fun bringing this one into the 21st century.
You love a challenge, don't you?
Yeah, I do. You sure you want to fix up this whole place all by yourself?
God, are you kidding me? This is like heaven. I love this house.
I know you do, but we can always get help. I'm sure there are plenty of contractors around out there.
No, I'm gonna do it myself. I wanna feel it come back to life.
If I remember correctly, that's exactly what you said about your old car.
I love my old car.
So you love the house, you love your car. What else do you love?
I love you. Most of the time.
Daddy! Daddy's home!
Baby, how are you, huh? Hey, Ma. Why don't we help Suzanne put out the food, okay?
Okay.
Just then, Happy jumped the safety, fooling the nasty alligator. And Happy
and his friends were reunited and lived happily ever after.
You go to sleep now. If you need us, we'll be just down the hallway.
Daddy?
Yes, Miss Molly?
What if Mommy comes back to our old house and we're not there?
Sweetheart, Mommy's not coming back.
Do you miss her, Daddy?
Of course I do, Mom. You know, some people believe that when people die and go to heaven, they watch over us all the time.
Do you believe that?
Yeah, I do. I love you.
I love you too.
How is she?
She's good. You know, sometimes she gets this look like she's 80 years old. She's like that from the moment she was born. I'll never forget she turned and looked at me like she'd been here before.
Sweetie, I want to have a baby soon.
Whoa. That's one hell of an opening line.
I know. It's just that we have our new home, our new life. I don't know what we're waiting for anymore.
Molly's been through a lot. I really want her to be settled before she has another big change in her life.
Molly is a wonderful, resilient little girl. I'm sure she would love having a little baby brother or sister.
Yeah, I know she will.
Okay, I'll give you 3 months. Not one day longer.
A deal. In the meantime, how about we get in a little practice?
Maybe we should sleep in another room.
No, it's over, Suzanne. I'm just gonna take Molly here back to her bed.
No, I'm scared. I want to stay here.
Oh, yeah? Okay. Come on. Jump. Jump in. There we go. Come on. Atta girl. You all right, Suzanne? Okay, I appreciate it. Thanks. Damn, 8:30 already. Honey, I gotta go.
Wait. What did the contractor say?
He says it's no big deal. He reckons the chimney got blocked at some point and all the activity dislodged the stones. He's gonna send someone over to fix it up.
Okay.
Unless, of course, you want to do it yourself.
Oh, very funny.
I'll be late. Don't wait up for me.
Okay. Have a good day.
You bet.
Better package goods, consumer services, and travel. Chicago was great. This place is amazing.
Primary Plant takes the product right from the forest to the hardware store. This place may be old, but it still works.
I'm really looking forward to turning things around, making it a competitor again.
Well, you're the third guy to try. Every time we get bought out, they send in a guy like you, comes in, tries to dig us out of a hole.
This time will be different, John. You wait.
Hasn't been different so far.
I'm so glad you liked it. You don't think it was overdone? Oh, really?
What's your name?
Gee, Candace,
now be careful. It's very, very hot. Try one of these. They're cucumber, my favorite. We used to live in Chicago. It was freezing cold there. My mommy's dead, too. She had black hair. She smelled like daisies.
You want a pillow? Here, take this one. I'll leave the light on so you won't be afraid of the dark.
Hey, sweetie. Who are you talking to?
Nobody.
You know, when I was a little girl, I had a pretend friend. Her name was Linda, and she was very pretty. She had beautiful hair, just like yours. And I used to tell her all of my secrets. Do you have a pretend friend, sweetie?
She's not pretend. She's real.
Well, of course she is. What's her name?
Candace.
Well, hello, Candace. It's very nice to meet you. Are you two girls ready for bed?
Yes.
Good. Good night, Pumpkin. Good night, Candace. One for Molly, one for Daddy, one for Suzanne, and does Candace like pancakes?
Candace loves pancakes.
Yeah? One for Candace.
Not there!
That's, Candace's chair.
Candace?
Her imaginary friend. I had one when I was her age. It's not that unusual.
You also had a teddy bear you called Uncle Henry.
Hey, you dissed my house. You dissed my car. And now you're dissing my bear. Let me just tighten you up a little bit tighter.
I love you.
I love you, too.
I think I'll call the school summer camp, see if they can fit her in. She needs to be around some real kids.
Glad we discussed it. Hi, Molly. We are so glad that you've come to play with us today. Come with me. This is Megan. She's my daughter, and she's going to be your special helper today. Show Molly her cubby, will you, Meg?
Okay.
I'll pick you up after lunch, okay? Fine. I see you guys live close to us. Maybe we can carpool when she gets settled in.
That'd be great. Yeah, thank you. Julie, if you need me, just give me a call, okay?
Don't worry. I'll take extra good care of this little sweetie.
Bye.
Hi.
Hi there. Thank you so much for volunteering your time.
Ah, the pleasure's all mine.
Residents are really looking forward to slapping that paint around.
Well, you know, you're never too old to be an artist. Besides, I live just down the road, I'm practically neighbors.
I can't find my sister.
Good morning, Dora. Good to see you up getting your exercise.
Have you seen her? Have you?
Good. Let's see here. So bleeding, but no boo-boos. No open wounds.
Nope.
Do you have any pets, Molly?
No, and be careful. You're sitting on my friend.
Oh.
Molly has an imaginary playmate.
Oh, what's your friend's name, Molly?
Candace.
Well, hello, Candace. It's very nice to meet you. Now, Molly, the nurse is going to take you and Candace out to the waiting room while I talk to your mom and dad, okay?
Suzanne's not my mom.
Oh, okay. Well, Suzanne and your dad are going to be 2 minutes. Maybe three.
So what do you think? Why was she bleeding?
Well, my hunch is that it was probably just a bleeding nose. She's obviously far too young to be menstruating, but if it happens again, you bring her back in.
Okay.
What about the invisible friend?
Michael, it's no big deal. Come on. Lots of kids have them, right?
Well, actually, 50% of kids have an imaginary friend at some point. Usually at around age 5, but that can vary. Molly's a prime candidate. She's got a great imagination, no siblings, and you guys just moved.
But does it mean something's troubling her? She lost her mom less than 2 years ago.
Molly is a healthy little girl. I wouldn't worry at all. She's going to be through this phase before you even know it.
So did you have a chance to have a look at her?
Yeah, well,
better. Hi, guys. See you later, Molly.
Bye.
Candace, you try.
Oh, Candace is here? Hello, Candace.
Know what, Suzanne?
What?
Candace really likes you.
She does?
Yes. She wants to know if she can call you Mommy.
Of course she can call me Mommy. I'd love that.
Candace has had a very hard life.
Well... Okay, let's cover it. Let it simmer.
Her other mommy died when she was 10. She died in childbirth.
That's a very big word.
Candace was very lonely and very sad. But she's happy now, because we're her family, and we'll love her forever and ever. Candace says you're the best mommy in the whole world, and she loves you a lot.
Will you tell her that I love her, too?
Alligators don't eat cookies. The nasty alligator trip happened.
What does Candace look like?
Long hair, this tall.
What color hair?
Brown with a blue ribbon on top.
And what is she wearing?
A purple dress, down to here, with an apron thingy on top.
Like this?
Yes.
And the shoes?
Brown with little buttons on the side.
I'm going to put the two of you in a book that I'm illustrating. And see if you will be immortalized.
What's immortalized mean?
It means that you'll live forever.
Thank you. I love this. This is Beatrice. Oh, and her sister Elizabeth. This is Princess Penelope. Suzanne told me she's a bad role model. And this is Jane. Jane's my favorite. Do you have any dolls? Show me!
Molly, are you dressed yet? Julie will be here soon.
We'll be down in a minute!
Are you sure we should be in here? All right. She's beautiful. What's her name? Hello, Emily. Maybe she and Jane can be friends.
Molly!
They'll be best friends for life.
Hey, what are you still doing up here?
Playing.
I know this is your first time going to school with Julie, but you're gonna be fine. Hey, where'd you get her?
In the attic. There's a chest full of toys.
Molly, you really shouldn't be going up to the attic alone.
I wasn't alone. Candace was with me.
Hey, here. Come on. Let's go. Thank you.
Hey, baby, how are you?
Good, good. You're coming home for dinner, yes?
No, sorry, I was just going to call you. I got pulled into a town council meeting.
Oh, and you've got to go?
Are you kidding? The spotlight will be on yours truly. He'll be wowing them big time. Is everything okay?
Yeah, everything's fine. Okay, so we'll just see you later then.
Okay, bye, darling.
Hi, sweetie. Thanks, Julie.
No problem. She's a gem.
Thanks.
Why don't you stop by for tea one afternoon?
Oh, that'd be great.
So, how was your day?
I like my old school better.
Yeah, I know, but you'll get used to it. Megan seems nice.
She's okay. Mm-hmm.
You okay?
Uh-huh, we're fine!
Let go!
What's going on in there?
Let go! Stop it!
Mom?
Come on. Here we go. There you go. All right. You're all right.
You're okay, sweetie.
You're okay. It's okay, baby. It's okay.
Be careful.
Okay, I'll tell her. Candace says she's sorry it was an accident.
Okay, sweetie. Just have to be more careful. Slipping in the tub is very dangerous. I want you to go to bed, okay?
Okay.
No more talking.
Suzanne?
Yeah, Mom?
Candace wants you to put the things back.
What things, sweetie?
The stuff you found in the attic. She wants you to put it back where it was.
How did you know about that?
Candace told me.
But, sweetie, Candace isn't real. She's pretend.
Don't be silly. Of course she's real. She's sitting right here.
Where are we going? I want to finish my sandwich.
You gotta see this. I don't understand. How did Molly know about it?
Maybe she saw it. You said she'd come up here. Look, all old houses have lots of junk. I wouldn't worry about it.
Michael, it's not junk. It's a hex. And Molly knew about it. How did she know? And what about this room? I mean, what is this?
Looks to me like a perfect spot for a nice little playroom.
Come inside. It's horrible. And why was it sealed up? Huh? I mean...
Maybe, the Oogie Boogie Man lives here.
Don't laugh at me, okay?
I'm sorry. I just think you're getting a little carried away. This is an old house, so this room was sealed up years ago. A lot of people sealed up old rooms to save on heat. Let's just get rid of this, okay? It's disgusting.
No, you can't do that. You can't just toss it. It's bad luck.
Suzanne, it stinks.
Men think your only goal is to maximize the profits for the company. They really don't see how any of these changes are going to benefit them.
And try this approach. We're modernizing the operation to make sure that their way of life continues. When we fly in, we lift out only the trees that we want to harvest. That way, we leave the young timber to grow, so there's plenty left for their kids and their grandkids to harvest.
I'll give it a shot.
Thanks. Hey, John. I appreciate it.
Okay, everybody, lunch. Lunchtime.
Come on, Molly, we gotta go inside now.
Be there in a second.
I shall find baby on the treetops. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. When the bell breaks, the cradle will fall. And down will come baby, cradle.
She just made that yesterday.
I'm sure she.
Hey, Rob.
Hey.
Hi.
I didn't know you worked here.
Yeah, I'm trying to be a useful member of the community.
Yeah, I'm the on-call doctor here.
Huh.
Yeah, this is my old friend Dora. We're just going for a walk. Dora, this is Suzanne. I'm her daughter's doctor.
Hi, Dora. It's nice to meet you. I think I saw you last week. Your daughter's very pretty. Oh, you met my stepdaughter?
Hello, Candace. What a lovely name.
Mm-hmm. Would you excuse me?
What's this for? Finish. Suzanne, wait. Suzanne.
Look, was that some kind of a joke?
Of course not.
Well, how did she know about Candace?
I have no idea.
Well, did you mention to her that Molly had an imaginary friend? And she was acting like she could see somebody.
Look, I'm sorry if she upset you.
I'm sorry, it's just... This is all just a little too weird. I mean, first Molly last night, and now this.
Wait, what happened last night?
Nothing, forget it.
Suzanne, tell me.
Hey, Sally.
She's napping. I gotta run. I'm late for another job.
Great, thanks.
Could you just put these inside, please? Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks, we won't see you soon.
This is gorgeous.
Thanks, Michael made it. He'd do it full time if he could. But, you know, health benefits, security.
And the drawings are beautiful.
Thanks. I work for a publisher. Just trying to keep it going long distance. These are for a book of fairy tales. Huh. You want one?
Sure. Thanks.
Hey. I found this in a bend in the attic. Part of the attic was sealed off like it was someone's bedroom. And the creepy thing is that Molly knew about it. She says that Candace told her.
Looks like some kind of old voodoo hex thing.
Yeah, that's what I thought. But why corn?
Well, corn is a symbol of life. Sustenance. It's used to feed the hex, make it more potent. I'd say this one was aimed at the man. I guess this would be his hair. And his fingernails. Personal artifacts are used to give the spell more focus and strength. It's ugly stuff.
How do you know about all this?
Now, Dora, she's always been in this mumbo-jumbo. Growing up, she was the town eccentric, you know, reading our poems, that kind of thing.
And do you believe in it?
No. No, I think it can have a powerful effect on those who do.
Okay, so how do you explain what's going on here? I mean, how did Dora know about Candace?
She's always said that she had the gift. You know, psychic. She's scarily perceptive. Even more so now that she has Alzheimer's. Maybe she picked up something from you. I mean, you act as if Candace is a real kid.
Yeah.
It's not just Molly.
Hello, are you at home?
We're in the kitchen.
Hey, Michael.
Doc? What's going on? I fell Molly on the stairs.
I woke up. I couldn't find you.
Oh, sweetie, I'm sorry. We were just in here talking.
I thought we threw that out.
What are these?
Molly, don't touch that.
I told her to put it back!
What are you doing? Stop it! Stop it!
Molly, calm down, baby. Calm down, it's all right. Nice one, Suzanne. Goodbye, Doc. Suzanne, this woo-woo nonsense, it's making me crazy. That includes this imaginary friend. Why are you encouraging this?
Michael, don't you think there's something going on in this house?
You want to know what's going on? Someone planted this here to scare us off. Well, I won't be scared.
Yes, this is she. Are you sure? Thank you.
Basically, they want more input. They want to have a voice in the restructuring. Every decision gets put to a vote.
That's crazy, John. I'm here because it's my job to tackle these kinds of problems and offer workable solutions. If we get bogged down in committee meetings, nothing will get done. I'll be the third guy to come here and the third guy to fail. Yeah.
Baby, what's wrong? Are you all right?
I couldn't wait. I'm pregnant.
What?
Yes. Yeah, I know. I was surprised too. They say that the diaphragm's not 100% effective.
I'm so happy. Michael, tell me how happy you are.
I am. I'm happy, too. I am.
I was thinking maybe you and me and Molly could go out for a nice special dinner tonight to celebrate her being a new sister.
I don't think we should tell Molly right away.
Why not?
I don't want her to feel like she's being replaced.
Michael, I love Molly. She's never going to be replaced.
I know. Just let me tell her first, okay? All right.
Yeah, okay. Where's the babysitter?
In the house. Where were you?
Just out running a few errands. I'm sorry, Janet. I'm gonna need a little more time.
I thought you were almost done. Is everything okay?
Yeah, everything's fine. In fact, it's better than fine.
Don't tell me. You're knocked up.
What? How did you know?
You sound like the cat who swallowed the cream. Hey, congratulations.
Thanks.
And tell Michael, attaboy.
I would. Bye.
What are you doing?
He'll see. If it moves in an oval, the baby will be a girl. It makes a straight line, it's a boy.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Let me give it a try. Oh, looks like it's gonna be a boy. No, wait. It's a girl. No.
You're making fun of me. Stop it.
What's wrong?
Oh, good.
Oh. This cut is bad, Suzanne. I should get you to the emergency room.
No, it's okay. It's almost stopped bleeding.
Molly, what happened?
It wasn't me.
Then how did it break?
Candace did it.
Candace didn't do it. Now cut it out. Suzanne is hurt.
Michael, it's okay. Come on.
No. No, it's not okay. Molly, you have to stop with this imaginary playmate nonsense. She's not going to take the fall for this.
It was Candace. Why won't you believe me?
Molly, Candace isn't real. You know that.
She is so. She is real. She's right over there. How can you say that?
Molly.
This is getting way out of control, Suzanne. Molly doesn't know the difference between reality or fantasy anymore.
Sweetie, come here.
I want my daddy. It wasn't me, Daddy. It really wasn't.
All right, okay.
Candace got really mad.
Why? Why did she get really mad, sweetie?
She says you have a baby inside you, and you're hiding it from us. Is it true? Is there a baby inside you?
Sweetheart. Suzanne and I were going to tell you very soon.
Molly, you're going to have a little baby brother or sister.
I have a sister.
It's going to be wonderful. Please don't be unhappy.
I'm not unhappy. Candace is.
Why, sweet pea? Why is Candace unhappy about the baby? Tell me. I really want to understand.
She thinks you don't love her anymore. You said you'd be her mommy, and now
you don't want her.
Just have a seat. So I've evaluated Molly, and you were right. She has a very strong belief in her imaginary friend. It's much more elaborate and creative than we normally see. I have a couple questions I need to ask you both. Molly's mother died 2 years ago?
Yeah, she had breast cancer.
I'm sorry. And you two met a year later?
I know it seems like it happened fast, but Suzanne and I met, and it felt right. We didn't want to just date. I thought a concrete step would be best for Molly, so...
And how did Molly react to that?
She had mixed feelings, I think, but fairly typical.
So she accepts you as her stepmother?
I asked her if she wanted to call me Mommy, but she said no. And I respected that. I'm not her mother. But that's why when she asked me if Candace could call me Mommy, I thought it was a real breakthrough. Don't you think?
I'm not sure yet. You see, Molly's very aware of your own desire for your own child. She may have created this imaginary girl to give you the child that you're wanting. But now that a real child is coming, she may feel that her creation is being threatened. She may also have created this other self to express her complex feelings about you, Suzanne. Things that she needs to work through.
I agree. That's why I didn't want to have another child right away.
This pregnancy wasn't planned?
Not by me.
What is that supposed to mean? You think I got pregnant deliberately? That is so unfair. Like, I have tried so hard to give and to this family and to reach out to Molly and...
Suzanne, we're just trying to lay out the undercurrents of the family.
Well, maybe there's something more going on here. I mean, how do you explain the fact that Candace tells Molly things, but that weird things are happening?
Like the attic?
How did you know about that? You guys talked already, didn't you?
Suzanne, I think it's important not to overreact to seemingly odd occurrences. You see, Molly is already living with one foot in reality and one in fantasy. I think that everyone else, especially the adults in her life, they need to firmly differentiate between the two.
Yeah, okay.
I'm sorry, we're out of time. I'll see you both in a couple of weeks.
Why did you do that? Did you talk to her without telling me?
We talked on the phone. That's all.
You made me out to be some kind of hysteric. And how dare you suggest that I got pregnant intentionally?
Suzanne, you're overreacting again.
You know, if you want Molly to start treating me like a mother, you need to start treating me like an equal parent.
Hi, Dora.
Dora?
What is it?
Wear this. It will protect you.
I'm sorry. I was taking Dora to the dentist and she just insisted on coming by here first.
It's okay.
Come on, Dora. We're going to be late for our appointment.
Suzanne, play with us, please.
sweetie, I'm really busy right now. Sorry.
Pretty please, Suzanne.
Okay. Just for a little while.
Go!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ready or not, here I come. Suzanne, beg it
this way. Suzanne.
Stuck in the garage. Molly! I'm sure it was an accident. Sorry. Molly! 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 Didn't you hear me calling you? What are you doing? You know you're not supposed to leave the yard alone.
It's okay. I wasn't alone. Candace brought me down here to visit her other mommy.
Brewer.
This is real. Michael? Michael, I need to talk to you. Michael? I'm really worried about Molly.
I'm worried about Molly too, Suzanne.
Would you please stop? Listen to me. There was a girl named Candace who lived in this house about 100 years ago. I found her journal pages up in that weird room up there.
Couldn't it just be a coincidence that someone named Candace lived here once upon a time?
No. The grave that Molly went and visited today, the people in the grave, the Brewers, they were Candace's parents. Candace Brewer was her name. All the dates match up.
I don't care, Suzanne. I don't care about people in graveyards. I care about today. I care about my daughter.
Look, Michael, there's something going on that Molly's hooked into. I mean, even Rob's concerned. I called him and I asked him to see her again.
Molly's not seeing Rob anymore. He's out of his depth.
I didn't make up what happened today. Candace is a real girl.
I told you, Suzanne. I don't want any of this around my kid. From Rob or from you.
It's not me, Candace. It's Daddy. He says I'm not supposed to talk to you anymore. I'm really sorry.
I'm sorry it's not my decision. I've been the one defending you up until now.
Defending us? From what?
As you know, the parents are very involved here. You will, of course, get a full refund.
Half the fathers here work at the mill. Would that have anything to do with this decision?
Look, I know it's hard to be accepted here, especially in your position. But the parents have noticed things about your daughter. They talk. The incident with Megan was the last straw.
She's 7 years old. How could you all just turn against such a young child? She's going to come back here in the fall for regular school.
Oh, screw it. I've had enough of this crap.
Suzanne, I'm really sorry.
Molly, come on.
We're leaving.
A big improvement from last week, huh? It's beautiful. It's a lovely shade of blue. Dora. Hi.
Hello, Suzanne. Hello, Candace.
Listen, I don't believe in this stuff.
No one does until it happens to them. A boy is coming.
A boy?
Yes, a good, strong boy.
Okay. Supposing I do believe. Why is Candace still in the house? What does she want from us?
A family. Love. Everything she didn't get before.
She's scaring us. I don't want her in my home anymore.
The problem is, you let her in. You gave her strength. You gave her a normal childhood that she never had. And now, you're taking it away.
I didn't believe that she was real. She's not real.
Sometimes they cannot leave. Sometimes they have to undo what happened to them. Tell me what happened, child.
What does she say?
Something terrible happened. But she won't tell me what it is. She said it's not for me to know. Be very careful. Candace is very, very angry.
Your daughter scared you last week coming to the cemetery, hmm?
Yeah, she did. Listen, it's odd. The people in the grave, Father, the Brewers, they used to live at our house. Brewers had a daughter, Father. She's not buried with them.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
In those days, next of kin were always buried with their families. Do you know her name?
Candace.
Candace. Yes, here she is. I knew I'd seen the name.
Why isn't she buried with the rest of her family? What is this place?
This is unhallowed ground. Just means it's not sacred. Back then, sinners were buried here. These souls are on their own, I'm afraid.
But she was only 10 years old. What could she have done? Suicide. That counts as a sin. 10-year-old Candace Brewer was found hanged in her backyard on Wednesday night. Her father, Dr. Emmett Brewer, said his daughter was distraught following her mother's death earlier that day during childbirth. The apple tree.
Hey, baby.
Can I sleep here?
Of course you can, sweetheart. Come on in. Girl. There you go. Snuggle up.
Where's Suzanne?
I don't know, baby.
Candace says she's with Rob.
Is just upstairs to the left.
Yeah.
I'm coming!
Oh, God.
Oh, it's okay. It's all right. Come here, let me see. Oh.
Tell me what's going on.
I don't know.
It's Candace, isn't it? Tell me.
She's with me all the time. She's right here on the chair.
It's okay. It's okay, because I'm here too.
Shut up! I don't want to hear!
What is she saying, baby? What is she saying? What is it?
It's so sad.
What? What is so sad? Tell me, tell me.
She said the baby won't be coming after all.
Why would she say that?
Candace said you're her mommy, not the baby.
Go inside, Suzanne.
Everything's gonna be okay now, Michael. I told Candace that she had to leave us alone.
Okay, that's good. Okay, let's go inside. We need to rest.
I'd like to leave a message for Dr. Barrett. When is she back in town? Okay. Have her call Michael Driscoll as soon as she can.
Mr. Driscoll, we did everything we could, but she's lost the baby.
It's my fault. I made Candace real, and now she killed the baby.
No, baby, no, it's not your fault. It's not your fault, baby.
Nobody's fault.
I could hear Molly. She was hysterical.
She's been sedated.
What? She's here.
Baby.
Mike, I'm so sorry.
Baby, she's gonna get through this, okay? You wanna keep her overnight for observation?
What are we gonna do? I mean, how can everything just go so wrong?
Everything's gonna be fine, sweetie. Everything's gonna be fine. They said you can go home if you're ready.
Terrible. Feel better soon, love. And tell Michael, thanks for sending the galleys back. We'll try again next time.
Why did you send my work back? You had no right to make that decision for me.
I'm sorry, Suzanne, but I care about you.
You should be in bed. Work is the last thing you need right now.
Isn't that for me to decide?
Look at how upset you're getting. You have to rest. You have to try and stay calm.
I just had a miscarriage, Michael. I should be upset. Why are you so calm?
Because maybe someone has to be.
Oh, for heaven's sake, just put them in!
Are you afraid of Michael finding out that there are things in this world that don't fit so nice into neat little boxes?
Why are you attacking me? Don't you think that I feel bad? I lost the baby too, Suzanne.
Time to wake up, baby. It's breakfast time. Mom? No, I don't think you're crazy. I do think you're under a lot of stress, though.
Do you want to come inside? I gotta get some Kleenex.
Sure.
What would drive a 10-year-old to hang herself? Kids that age don't usually commit suicide.
On very rare cases, they do. If they're pushed to the edge. Didn't the newspaper say that her mother died in childbirth earlier that day?
Okay, so she saw her mother die a horrible, painful death, and then she killed herself? What happened to the baby?
I assume it died as well.
Well, where is it?
Probably buried with the mother.
Then why wasn't the name on the gravestone?
I don't know. Babies usually are. Even if they're stillborn.
Rob, what if the baby lived? And if it did survive, then why did Candace, the big sister, kill herself?
Dr. Barry, thank you. Thank you so much for coming.
You're welcome. Brain scan is clear. No tumor, no signs of epilepsy or other neurological problems.
Thank God.
They've also ruled out a viral infection or an anomaly like a spider bite.
You're saying it must be psychological.
Yes.
Why is she sleeping so much?
I'm afraid she's slipping into a state of catatonia.
But why? Why?
Molly? Molly, can you hear me? It's Dr. Barrett. Molly.
It's my fault. Candace killed the baby. I should have stopped her.
Maybe that her guilt is consuming her. The part of Molly that was threatened by the baby coming. The part that she calls Candace. She may believe that those bad thoughts caused the miscarriage.
What can we do?
Well, I'm putting in a call to Benjamin Harding. He's a researcher at Berkeley. He specializes in these kinds of cases.
We can't just stand by and wait.
No, we have to somehow convince Molly that Candace has no power. We have to help her rid herself of Candace. I have to go. I'll get back to you tomorrow. Ben, it's Gail Barrett. Call me as soon as you can. I got a case for you that really takes the cake. Yes, this is Dr. Barrett. I'm taking care of Molly Driscoll, yes? I gave strict instructions about the medication. Is she agitated? I can't be any more clear. If there are any other changes, you can call again, but I do not want her speaking to Candace.
Molly, baby. Hey. Baby, wake up. Hey. It's Suzanne.
Hello, Mommy.
Hi. Been so worried about you. Sweetie, I need to ask you a very important question about your friend Candace.
Yes, Mommy.
How did she die, sweetie? What did she tell you?
I'm not dead, Mommy.
Of course you're not. I'm talking about your friend Candace. Did she have a baby brother or sister? Huh? What happened on the day that she died?
I'm not dead, Mommy! I'm not dead!
Oh, my God.
Hold me, Mommy. Please hold me.
Baby.
I'm not dead!
What is this? Get out of here now!
It's not...
Get out of here!
It's not Molly!
Get them
Candace.
Out!
Candace!
What are you doing? What are you doing? If you've gone completely mad.
Didn't you just see her in there? Michael, that wasn't Molly. That was Candace. Candace has taken
Leave
over
Leave her alone. Do you hear me? Don't come back here again. And you son of a...
Don't! Stop it.
your wife. I was just trying to help.
Trying to help? This isn't helping her, Suzanne. This is killing her. Now, please. I have to take care of my daughter.
You have to stop her. She's undoing what happened. She's a bad girl.
Laura, tell me what to do.
It's in the pages. Look more closely. Hurry.
Dora, calm down, all right? Sure, hurry, through the roof. Get out of the room, now. Hey, I need a monitor in that room now. You okay?
I have to help my family. Mama took Father to Belmont. She says his mind is sick. Father came home today. He's very quiet. Mama says we'll leave as soon as the baby is born. Father O'Donnell is trying to help.
Daddy. I want to go home now.
Doctor wants you to stay a little bit longer, okay?
Please, Daddy, take me home. I hate this place. Please?
All right, Bunker. We're out of here.
I thought you might be back. I looked in the old church records. Yes, there was Father O'Donnell. I found these letters he wrote, asking the Holy Sisters to take in Candace and her mother. There was terrible abuse in the house. I also found these. Candace's father was treated in a mental hospital.
Belmont.
Yes, that's it. He died there. Before he died, Brewer asked for confession. The priest was tormented. He wrote in his journals about his conflict, his guilt.
Why?
He thought Brewer had killed Candace. He'd hanged his own daughter.
He hanged her?
I believe he did.
Candace's father killed her. Candace needs to kill her father. Oh my God, Michael.
Say it, but you have.
Daddy. Daddy, where are you?
I'm coming, Molly.
Michael? Molly? get away from him, Candace.
He killed me, Mama. He tried to kill my baby sister. My mother died when she was born.
Candace!
I saved her. I took her far away from him. Then he killed me. He hanged me in the garden.
I am not your mother, and he is not your father. You have to go now.
Michael,
come with me, Mommy. Your mommy's waiting. Can you smell her?
No.
Can you smell the daisies?
No. Mommy, don't listen to her.
Jump, Mommy, hurry. Your real mommy's waiting. Suzanne doesn't love you. She'll...